This is a 30 minutes beginner's daily yoga routine that you can do at home. With this unpredictability surrounding the world in the pandemic, this video is focused on channelizing our energy in learning the divine practice of yoga. If you are a complete beginner to yoga or someone with basic experience, then this video will properly introduce you to the heavenly world of asanas and pranayam, making your body healthy and mind calm. This video is in association with Mama Earth's natural Upton face wash. Well, more about it later. Now let's get started with the video. One more thing, this video is not just to watch, but to follow along. So come on, let's do it together.
Hello friends, welcome to FitTuber. Every morning after waking up, drink water, freshen up, and get ready to practice yoga, preferably outdoors, without eating anything. All you would need is a yoga mat and an open mind to start with. Yoga mat preferably made of cotton, wool, or you can even use a towel or a bed sheet. It is important to prevent the earthing of the energy that will get generated in your body. The effectiveness of doing yoga multiplies when we begin by proper lubrication of the joints. So let's do that with a quick warm up, rhythmically moving up from toe to head. Stand straight, facing the east direction. Starting with the left toe, move it up and down 5 times. Now lift the right toe and in the same way, move it up and down for 5 times. Moving up, lift your left leg a bit and rotate it 5 times in clockwise direction and then 5 times in anti-clockwise direction. These micro exercises are called yogic sukshma vyayam. Now similarly, lift the right leg and rotate it 5 times in clockwise direction and then 5 times in anti-clockwise direction. Yoga is all about doing comfortably at your own pace with a positive state of mind. Now bend your knees, place your palms on it, and then rotate them clockwise and then anti-clockwise 5 times each. These seemingly minor exercises are powerful as they activate the subtle channels of the body. Now place your hands on the waist and rotate it 5 times clockwise and then 5 times in an anti-clockwise direction. Any stiffness in the back, you will feel an instant relaxation. This light warm-up will loosen all the joints by removing the excess air bubbles that get trapped in them. Now we will lubricate the joints of our arms. Move them, rotating the wrist sideways, and then clench and relax 3 times. Go back and this time bring them forward. This exercise will tone your arms, making the wrist stronger and gripping power better. This time, go up. Do it with complete involvement and a smile on your face. Now place your fingers on the shoulders like this and rotate them forward and then backward 5 times each. Do it slowly, making a circle without straining yourself at any moment. Now with your hands on your waist, rotate your neck 3 times, first in clockwise direction and then 3 times in anti-clockwise direction. Do it at your own pace, rotating it properly. Feel the tension getting released off your neck muscles. Very effective in preventing cervical problems. Now hold your ears and move them clockwise and anti-clockwise 5 times each. The nerves that increase pragya, that is awareness, is located in our ears. Moving to eyes. Roll your eyes clockwise 3 times and then 3 times in anti-clockwise direction. Now squeeze your eyes tight and then open them wide 5 times. In this day and age, eye muscles definitely need a lot of exercise. So this completes the warm-up to increase the flow of pranic energy throughout the body. Well done. Now our body is ready to do Surya Namaskar. It is a powerful kriya to instill the sun's energy within you. Let's do it with a sense of gratitude to the sun for sustaining life on our planet. Facing the sun, come to the edge of the mat. Hold Anjali Mudra. Take a deep breath in and lift your arms up and back. Now breathing out, bend forward and bring the hands down to the mat beside the feet. Do it comfortably. Now breathing in, push your left leg as back as possible. Right knee being in the front. Look up. Now take back your right leg also. Move your back up with eyes on the navel. Now gently bring your knees down to the floor and exhale. Rest your chest and chin on the floor. Then slide forward and raise your chest up into cobra pose. Look up. Now breathing out, lift the hips to bring your body into an inverted V pose. Take a deep breath in and this time bring your left foot forward in between the two hands. Breathing out, bring your right foot forward. Now stand up. Take a deep breath in, raise your hands up and bend backwards. As you exhale, first straighten the body, then bring your arms down sideways. Relax. How do you feel? Not just on the body, Surya Namaskar is known to have an immense positive impact on the mind as well. Now lie down on the mat. Before moving on to the breathing exercises, we will practice 6 asanas which are relevant and effective in curing our modern day health problems. First is Wind Relieving Pose, the Pavan Muktasana. Arms beside the body, palms facing the ceiling, legs together. Breathe in and as you exhale, bend both your knees and bring them towards your chest. Interlock your fingers, press your thighs on the abdomen, lift your head and chest off the floor, trying to touch your nose and then your chin. Hold this position for about 10 seconds. As its name suggests, Pavan Muktasana massages the intestines, helping in digestion and release of abdominal gas. Now release your head, your hands and then your legs. Relax. Next is Markatasana, the monkey pose. Bend both your knees and keep them near to the hips. Spread both your arms at the level of your shoulders. Now turn both your knees together towards the right side, while your neck towards the left side. Hold it there for a few seconds. Breathe normally as your spine is gently being stretched. Now slowly come back to the previous position. This time move your knees towards the left while your neck towards the right. Hold here for a few seconds. Markatasana also promotes creativity, bringing our monkey mind to rest. Now come back to the previous position. Slowly stretch your knees down and relax. Moving on to the Naukasana, the boat pose. Keep your arms straight, fingers outstretched towards the toes. Take a deep breath in and as you exhale, lift your feet off the ground till about 45 degree angle is reached. Now stretch your arms towards the feet. Hold it there with your entire body weight on the buttocks. Highly beneficial in reducing the extra fat in the belly area, it strengthens the abdominal muscles. Feel the tension originating in your ab muscles. Now exhale slowly as you bring the body to the starting position and relax. Moving on to the queen of asanas, the Sarvangasana or the shoulder stand. If you find it difficult, you can instead do Ardhalasana. With one movement, lift your legs, buttocks and back so that you come up high on your shoulders. Support your back with the hands. Your weight should be supported on your shoulders and upper arms and not on your head and neck. Lift your heels higher as though you are putting a footprint on the ceiling. keep breathing deeply as you hold this pose for about 15 seconds. For Ardha Halasana, hold your body like that in L shape. Brain power, face glow, thyroid function, Sarvangasana is highly effective. Now without lifting the head, slowly bring your spine down completely to the floor. Relax for a few seconds. Feel the sensations within your body. Next is Badkonasana, popularly known as the butterfly pose. Sit with your spine erect. Now bend your knees and make an effort to bring the heels as close to the genitals as possible. Do it comfortably, as much as your body allows. Now take a deep breath in. Breathing out, start flapping both the legs up and down like the wings of a butterfly. Flap comfortably at your own pace for about 30 seconds. Keep breathing normally throughout. You can instantly feel the stretch. One of the best asanas for strengthening the pelvic region, it is highly recommended in PCOD and the problems related to menstruation and prostate. Relax by straightening the legs out in front. Moving on to the last asana, the Mandukasana or the frog pose. The ultimate asana for diabetes. First of all, sit in Vajrasana. Place your palms on the thighs facing the ceiling. Keep the thumbs inside and make fists with both hands, like that. Now place your fists firmly on the adjacent side of belly button, just like that. Now take a deep breath in, then exhaling it out, bend downwards. Hold your position close to the ground. Look in front. Hold your breath in this yoga posture for a few seconds, comfortably without straining. Feel the pressure exerted. Mandukasana exercises many important organs like pancreas, gallbladder, liver, and spleen. Then slowly come up with inhalation back to the original position. Relax. So these were the 6 yogic postures especially designed for our busy modern lifestyle. Well done. Now let us do breathing exercises. Sit straight either in Sukhasana, Ardha Siddhasana, Siddhasana or Padmasana. Whatever you are comfortable in. Spine should be erect, neck straight, hands in Dhyan Mudra. Smile on the face, radiating positivity. We will begin with chanting Om 3 times. Close your eyes with a mild focus in between your eyebrows. Take a deep breath in and slowly chant Om. Om is not a sound related to one particular religion. It is the primordial sound of the universe. Om refers to Atman, our self within, and the Brahman, the ultimate reality. Om unifies Atman with Brahman. The vibrations of this divine sound balances the body within, cleansing the aura. Now we will do Bhastrika or bellows breath. Back straight, eyes closed. Take a deep breath in through your nose and then exhale slightly forcefully through your nose. We will do this for a minute. With smile on face, with each deep inhalation, feel that the pranic energy from the universe is entering your body. And with each exhalation, feel that the negativity, impurities are flowing out. Bhastrika pranayam is staple among yogis as it instantly energizes the body and instills silence in the mind, heightening the senses, aptly called the yogic breath of fire. For any respiratory and sinus problems, Bhastrika is must. Spiritually, it is said that Bhastrika break opens the emotional and mental knots of a person that block his or her evolution. Now we will do Kapalbhati or rapid exhalation for 4 minutes. Back straight, eyes closed, body relaxed, mind calm. Take a deep breath in and then expel the breath with forceful contraction of the abdominal muscles. Yes, just like that. Throughout this kriya, try to keep a mild focus on your stomach area. Do not worry about inhaling, just focus on exhaling. The point between two exhalations is when your body will automatically breathe in. Its mechanism is similar to hand pumping the air in a bicycle. Here we are pumping breath out of the body. Kapalbhati literally translates to the shining forehead. And this is precisely what happens with regular practice of this yogic kriya. A forehead that glows not just from the outside, but also from the inside, making the mind illuminated. Aim for at least 60 outward strokes of breath in a minute. Slowly you can increase this number to 70, 80 or even in 3 digits. Progress slowly, there is no hurry. You can even count the exhalations in mind if you so wish. With every outward breath, feel that you are pushing the toxins out of your body. Your digestive system is being exercised. Your heart is pumping better. The liver is functioning better. The internal factory is getting cleaned up. The workers are at work and you are simply facilitating them. The regular practice of Kapalbhati Pranayam detoxifies all the systems in our body. It is that powerful. Fat loss is just a byproduct. Just like milk gets boiled faster if it is provided constant heat, the benefits of Kapalbhati are enhanced if it is done without a break. However, at no point overexert yourself. If need be, take rest for a second and then start again. In terms of circulating the blood, it is so effective that often it's compared to running. Kapalbhati has an energizing effect on the nerves and a refreshing effect on the brain. It strengthens the digestive system like no other. Gas, acidity, indigestion, low appetite, malabsorption, you name it. Daily Kapalbhati practice alone has the power to destroy these diseases from its very root. In our day-to-day life, we move our upper body while working. We move our lower body as well when we walk or climb the stairs. It's the middle portion that remains largely unmoved. That's where most diseases arise from. Kapalbhati doesn't let that happen. Kapalbhati naturally purifies the blood as well. That is why it is said that it keeps the face young and radiant. The 72,000 nadis or subtle channels that make our human body, Kapalbhati has the capacity to stimulate and clear their passage. Yogic pranayam is all about doing it with a calm, cheerful mind, with utmost faith and involvement. Now let us do Agnisar. Take a deep breath in. Then exhale completely. Now contract and expand the stomach as many times as you can. 10 times is a good number for a start. Slowly you can increase this number to even 3 digits. The positive impact of Agnisar is multiplied when done after Kapalbhati. Do it for 1 minute. The name Agnisar is derived from two Sanskrit words. Agni meaning fire, and sar meaning to flush. Agnisar kriya mainly affects the belly region and regulates the fire element in the body around the stomach and thus improves the process of digestion and relieves problems related to the stomach. It is said to balance the Manipur chakra near your belly. Next, we will do Jalandhar Bandh, also called the chin lock. Inhale slowly and deeply through the nose. Now hold the breath, contract the throat, and gently press the chin downward, almost touching the upper chest. Hold the bandh for as long as it is comfortable. Then relax the throat, raise the chin, and exhale slowly through the nose. Do it 3 times. In yogic lore, Jalandhar Bandh is considered of prime importance in getting over addictions of the body as well as the mind. Alcohol, smoking, excessive masturbation, even addiction to sugar and junk foods. Whatever may be your concern, take it as a thought and do this bandh. It tremendously increases the willpower. With regular practice of Jalandhar Bandh, holding breath for long times, it even stimulates the vagus nerve. Mentioned in Maharishi Patanjali's Ashtang Yoga, its practice gives an instant gratification. Next, we will do the Sheathali breath. Keep the spine upright, eyes closed. Now bring your tongue all the way out. Fold the sides of the tongue like a tube. Take a long deep inhalation through this tube. After the inhalation is complete, close your mouth and exhale through the nostrils. As the name suggests, it cools down the body, soothing internal inflammations. Can you feel the instant cooling effect? Let's do this for a minute. In the scorching heat of India's tropical climate, Sheathali breath is a useful tool to keep the internal body temperature in check. The cooling effect of Sheathali breath is penetrating and deep. Any issues pertaining to the body heat, ulcers, acidity, pimples, rashes, anger, stress, Sheathali breath has a healing effect. Feel the excess heat from your body getting flushed out. Cooling for the body, it rejuvenates the mind. Now we will do Anulom Vilom or alternate nostril breathing. With your right thumb, close the right nostril. Take a slow deep breath in through the left nostril. Place the middle 2 fingers closing the left nostril and exhale slowly but completely through the right nostril. In the same position, inhale deeply from the right nostril, release the fingers, place the right thumb again on the right nostril and exhale completely from the left nostril. This completes one circle of Anulom Vilom Pranayama. We will do this important kriya for 4 minutes. Do it slowly, keeping a mild focus in between your eyebrows. For deeper effect, take long deep inhalations, filling your lungs to their full capacity. And then exhale slowly, completely. Try to keep the time of inhalation and exhalation roughly the same. Anulom Vilom has earned the name Nadi Shodhan Pranayama. Nadi referring to channel, Shodhan means cleaning, and Pranayama is the technique. Ida and Pingala are 2 most important nadis in the human body. Ida or the moon channel connecting the left nostril corresponds to the right hemisphere of the brain. Pingala or the solar channel connecting the right nostril corresponds to the left side of the brain. When Anulom Vilom is practiced, these 2 nadis are cleansed. This brings about an equilibrium between the left and the right brain, which results in heightened states of awareness and perception. Physical health is then a byproduct. With every inhalation, feel the flow of prana entering your body. And with every exhalation, feel the impurities flowing out. Cleaning is going on at the deepest levels. It's no small feat. be mindful of it. Throughout, keep a mild focus in between your eyebrows. This is where the Agna Chakra is located. Anulom Vilom is considered Tridosh Nashak Pranayam, which means that it brings in balance between the three basic doshas in our body, namely Vata, Pitta and Kapha. So no matter what your body type is, Anulom Vilom will bring about an ideal balance within. Our mind has a tendency to keep regretting or glorifying the past and getting anxious about the future. Nadi Shodhan Pranayam brings the mind back to the present moment. There is a profound reason as to why it is done the way it is done. Why we first inhale from the left nostril? Why only the thumb is placed? Why the middle two fingers are used? To put it simply, it is to bring a balance between the five elements of which our gross body is made of. It clears the energy channels, ensuring free flow of prana to every organ of the body. Anulom Vilom is advanced, yet it is so easy to practice. Do it with a sense of gratitude, with a feeling that you have been given a chance to get connected to your inner self, your true nature. Moving on to the last practice of this yoga session, Bhramri or the bee breath. Thumbs closing the ears, index fingers just above your eyebrows and the rest of your fingers softly placed over your eyes. Touch the tip of your tongue to the palate, mouth closed. Concentrate in between your eyebrows. Take a long deep breath through your nostrils and breathe out, making a humming sound of Om. Do it 5 times. Keep your eyes closed and look through your third eye, the vast emptiness. Assume that you are sitting on the axis and this universe is revolving around you. Visualize that all the positive energies are getting emanated from your body in the form of humming sound of the bee. Stimulating the pineal and pituitary glands, it is a panacea for all problems related to the brain. Now before opening the eyes, bring your palms together and rub them vigorously and continuously for a few seconds and then place them on your eyes and face. Now slowly open your eyes. Peace, calm, serenity. That's what your body is emanating. Now lie down flat on the mat in Shavasana for a minute. It's like a yogic cool down. Each cell in your body is grateful to you for completing this session. Every organ in your body is elated. They are delighted, satisfied for being taken care of. Be proud of yourself. Be joyful. You have done it. Thank the universe. Promise yourself that you will remain cheerful all day long. Promise that you will be polite to others. Promise that you will treat everyone with love and respect. Promise that no matter what life throws at you, you will take it with a taste of your calmness. Well done. You have completed this yoga session. I bow down to the divine in you. I'll see you tomorrow again. Namaste.
So friends, how was it? I hope you enjoyed this yoga session. Feel free to take breaks in between. Yoga is all about being comfortable and calm. This is a beginner's routine, but do not underestimate the benefits that you can reap from it. Trust me, this 30 minutes daily yoga will take you a long way. You will thank yourself for the priceless happiness, calmness, and health that you will obtain from it. 1 week is good enough to experience the benefits. However, the key lies in being consistent. If you found this yoga session helpful and would want me to make more such sessions, please give it a big thumbs up.
If you are looking for a genuine toxin-free face wash, Mamaearth's Upton face wash is one good option in the Indian market. Go through its ingredients and you will find that it has no sulfates, parabens, EDTAs or other harsh chemicals added in it. Rather, it is made from safe chemicals along with herbal extracts of turmeric, saffron and various skin-friendly essential oils. Mamaearth's this tan removal Upton face wash is suitable for all skin types and can be used by both men and women. Mamaearth, this product is dermatologically tested and is made in India. To buy it, click on the link down in the description box. Do not forget to apply the special discount coupon to get 21% off on your order.
So friends, that's all for this video. You can now support my work by clicking on the join button below. Please do remember to subscribe to my channel, hit that bell icon so that you never miss a video from me. You can also follow me on Instagram. My name is Vivek. I thank you so much for watching.